Hello and welcome to another claymation tutorial. This time I'm going to show you how to make a woolly mammoth. You'll need the materials here on screen. I'll explain as we go along. The first thing I'm going to do is sculpt the body out of non-drying clay. Now, once this is all done, the body is going to be covered with artificial fur, so the color that you use here doesn't really matter. That's why I'm using these colors that I'm not really going to probably need later on for other models. This bright pink and purple, not usual colors for animals, so I'm just going to use those for this. Now, woolly mammoths were quadrupeds, obviously, and you'll want to make sure that the front legs are longer than the back legs and that the back isn't parallel to the ground. It sort of has this arch. And once you've got the legs and the body all smoothed out, you're going to take some brown clay and get little pieces of it and cover the bottoms of each of the feet. Now, the fur isn't going to cover the bottoms of the feet, so that's why you're going to be covering it up with actual brown coloration. That way you don't see, in this case, pink and purple on the feet. Next, you're going to attach the head, including the trunk, which is going to be a bit complicated because you're going to be sculpting the trunk around a piece of aluminum wire, which is flexible but firm, and that's important for stop motion because if the trunk were to be just made out of non-drying clay, it would droop to the ground whenever I have to hold it back up in a certain position for a frame. So if you have wire like this running through it, it prevents that from happening, and it can retain its shape. So I'm going to be using brown clay for the head and the trunk. Most of this is going to be covered with artificial fur again, but the tip of the trunk is going to be bare, so that's why you want to use brown clay at least for that part. The tip of a woolly mammoth's trunk had these two finger-like structures, which you can also see on the tips of the trunks of African elephants, and they used those for actually grabbing a hold of grass, which was their food, and yanking it out of the ground and carrying it back up to their mouths. So you'll want to make sure you add that detail. You'll also want to make sure that the trunk is long enough that it can reach the ground. You don't want to make it too long, you don't want to make it too short. And now that the general shape of the body is complete, you're going to add the tusks. Now the tusks are going to be made out of drying clay, since they're going to stay the same shape throughout the stop motion sequence. Woolly mammoths had much larger and more prominent tusks than elephants today, so they'll be much more upwardly curved. You'll want to make sure that both of the tusks are the same size, shape, and curvature, so that the animal looks symmetrical like it should be. Before you let the clay for the tusks dry, you'll want to press them up against the area where they're going to be attached. That way, they'll be flush with each other and they'll glue on more smoothly. And once they've actually dried, you can get some super glue and actually glue them into place. And next, you're going to add on the actual hair of the animal. And I'm going to be using some plush for the head and the trunk, and a different material for the rest of the body. It's going to be a bit tricky, so you may have to try a few times in order to get this right. What I'm going to do here is use a piece of string and wrap it around the trunk so that I can get a general idea of how wide around the strip of felt is supposed to be, and then I'll cut it at that appropriate size and length, and then wrap it around the trunk and glue it on. Make sure that you don't cover the fingers on the trunk. Something you'll want to keep in mind is that you want to make sure that the seam is at the back of the trunk, the part that's facing the body. If it were facing frontwards, like if you were looking at the mammoth head on and you saw that seam running down the middle of the trunk, it would look pretty fake. So you'll want to make sure that it's the other way around. After the super glue has dried, you can take the scissors and make whatever alterations you need. Like I said, it might require some trial and error to get this right. And next, you're going to use some more felt to cover the rest of the head, which is going to be even trickier, unfortunately. If it weren't for those tusks getting in the way, it would be a lot simpler, but the tusks need to be put on before the fur, so that it looks like the tusks are actually growing out of the animal and not just attached on later. After getting a piece of felt of appropriate size and cutting it up as need be, you can wrap it around the area of the mammoth that you're trying to cover and use some glue to attach it. Don't worry about the eyes, those will come later. The ears will also be attached later as well. If there are any empty spots where the felt isn't covering the clay, you can get some smaller pieces and attach those on as well. Make sure that it's completely seamless. And then you're going to apply some fur to the rest of the body. Now for this, I'm going to be using a completely different sheet of artificial fur that actually has these artificial hairs that are a bit longer and shaggier. I'm going to use the same technique I used for the trunk, where I wrap a piece of string around each of the legs individually to make sure that I cut the appropriate size for the strips of fur that I'm going to wrap around the legs. You'll also want to make sure you use a box cutter or an X-Acto knife to cut this part, rather than using scissors as you would with the actual felt, because you don't want to cut the individual hairs too short. And once you've got all of the pieces cut out the way they need to be, you can use the super glue to attach those around the legs. While we're on the subject of mammoth hair, it's noteworthy that mammoths didn't have the same length of hair year-round. Like a lot of mammals that live in colder climates, they had a winter coat and a summer coat, with the summer coat being a bit shorter. With woolly mammoths being portrayed against snowy backdrops almost all the time, it's easy to forget that the Ice Age wasn't completely cold and snowy year-round in all parts of the world. Mammoth Steppe, which is the area where woolly mammoths lived back during the Ice Age, was not covered in snow year-round. It looked more like a savanna during the summer. It was covered with grass, which is what woolly mammoths ate. Humans also lived in this area at this time, which brings me to the story that I had in mind for the video I'm using this model for. In the video, a campfire that wasn't extinguished properly by the humans that built it spreads out of control and causes a wildfire. This also happens to take place during autumn when the air is dry and fires are much more easy to spread. And all these unfortunate coincidences cause the death of the poor mammoth before it can make it to safety. So anyways, once you've finished with the legs, then you're going to get the torso, and you'll want to have two separate pieces of artificial fur cut out, with one side of the body being covered by one piece and another side being covered by another piece, with the seam running along the back. That way the hair is running off in either direction on either side of the animal. And once you've actually completed all that, you want to be on the lookout for any areas that weren't covered by the fur when you did the attachments. For example, you can see this little area here that wasn't quite covered up. So I'm going to get another piece of artificial fur, cut that out, and attach it there. And once the whole thing is covered head to toe in hair, as it should be, you can smooth it out so it looks more natural. And then you're going to make and attach the tail, which you can do by cutting out a little rectangular piece of artificial fur, getting some super glue along one edge of it, and then folding it lengthwise so that it looks more like a tail, and then you can just attach it on using the super glue. Next up comes the eyes. Now this part is also going to be a bit tricky because you're going to have to cut eye holes into the felt that's on the face of the animal. You can use a box cutter or scissors or clay tools. There's a clay tool that is basically a long sharp needle, and you can poke a hole in there, widen the hole, which you can see me doing, and then once you've gotten that all taken care of, you can insert the glass eye into that hole and attach it to the clay on the other side. If I were to just super glue the eye to the outside, it wouldn't really look right because the edges need to be covered by little hairs, so that's why it needs to be underneath the plush with an eye hole peeking through. And you'll do that with the other side as well. Again, it may take a while. You may need to use all three methods, using a box cutter, scissors, or anything else you can use. So now it's time to add the finer details. The tusks, as you can see, are smooth and clean and white, which is not at all what animal tusks look like in the real world. If you look at elephant tusks, for example, they've got years of wear and tear on them. They're all scratched up and dirty, and you want to make sure that your mammoth's tusks look the same way. So what I'm going to do is take some clay tools. I'm going to use the one that is basically a big needle and scratch the tusks, add some scars, maybe even chip off a few pieces. Really cover the entire thing with as many scars as you can. And then, once you're done with the scratches, you can add some dirt. Covering the tusks, the little dust and dirt particles will get into the scratches very nicely, and it'll look more realistic that way. And last but certainly not least, the ears. I'm going to cut out two little ears from the felt. You'll want to make sure that they're the exact shape and size. Keep in mind that these are not supposed to be like elephant ears, which are big. These are supposed to be woolly mammoth ears, and they're much smaller. Elephants live in warm environments, so they have big ears to fan themselves to cool themselves down. With woolly mammoths, they lived in colder regions, so their ears were smaller so that they wouldn't freeze as easily. So you'll take some super glue and attach the ears onto the sides of the head. Again, try to make sure that they're symmetrical so that it looks like a real animal. And once you've got that taken care of, you're pretty much all done. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to let me know in the comment section. And if you want to see me do clay videos with any other prehistoric creatures, send me your suggestions, and I will see you next time.